Intussusception. Intussusception means invagination of a segment of the gut into the lumen of the distal segment of the gut. Like this example, here the ileum invaginate into the distal part of the gut, which is colon. Anatomical types of intussusception. The commonest type of intussusception is the ileocecal valve invaginate into the cecum and the ascending colon. And this is called ileocecal intussusception. The leader of this intussusception is the ileocecal valve. And this leader is called the apex of intussusception. The ileum may invaginate into the distal ileum. And this is called ileoileal. And if ileoileal intussusception progress and enter into the colon distally, this type is called the ileocolic intussusception. Rarely, intussusception may occur by a segment of colon invaginate into the distal segment, and this is called the colicocolic intussusception. These are anatomical types. Clinically, there are two clinical types. Before we enter clinically, there is this type. In all the previous types, the proximal part of intestine invaginate into the distal part. There is only one exception of intussusception, which is this, in which the distal part of intestine invaginate into a proximal part. How? This is a famous operation which done in gastric surgery called gastrojejunostomy. And there is an anastomotic opening between the stomach and the jejunum. The jejunum distally may invaginate into the stomach proximally, and this is called retrograde intussusception, which means that the distal invaginate into the proximal part of the gut, while all other types of intussusception, the proximal invaginate into the distal part of the gut. The clinical types include infantile type, which occur in infancy and form the commonest cause for intestinal obstruction in infancy. This type, ileocecal intussusception, occur during infancy and called infantile type. While adult type may occur anywhere due to organic lesion like bulboid tumor or Meckel's diverticulum or submucous hematoma, bulge in the lumen of the intestine, and this bulge inside the lumen of the intestine stimulate hyperblastosis, and this hyperblastosis succeed to expel the bulboid tumor with the intestine distally. This type is called the adult type due to organic lesion like Meckel's diverticulum, bulboid tumor, or submucous hematoma. The commonest type of intussusception and the most important type which forms the commonest cause for intestinal obstruction in infancy is ileocecal intussusception. Ileocecal intussusception was the incidence of this type, in which the terminal ileum and the ileocecal valve is the leader or the apex of intussusception enter into the cecum and the ascending colon. The incidence of this condition is very, very important because it is the commonest type of intussusception and is the commonest cause for intestinal obstruction in infancy. The condition is slightly more in male to female ratio is 2 to 1. The maximum age incidence is from 3 months to 12 months, which is usually the age of weaning. The peak incidence of ileocecal intussusception during summer. Why during summer? Due to the peak incidence and the highest incidence of gastroenteritis, which may play an important role in ileocecal intussusception. What is the etiology of intussusception? The etiology of intussusception is idiopathic, but there is theory. The most famous theory is that gastroenteritis or infection with adenovirus leading to hypertrophy and the enlargement of the lymphoid follicles in the terminal ileum, which are called Peyer's patches. Hyperplasia and hypertrophy of Peyer's patches leading to bulge of these lymphoid tissues inside the lumen. This bulge inside the lumen stimulate hyperbristalsis in the terminal ileum. And this hyperbristalsis may succeed to push the ileocecal valve into the cecum, starting the process of ileocecal intussusception. Also, there is some predisposing factor may predispose the infant for this intussusception, which is normal ileocecal angle is obtuse angle, wide angle. But in some infants, the ileocecal angle may like that, acute angle, leading to some sort of ileocecal invagination into the cecum. And any hyperbristalsis will allow traveling of the ileocecal valve inside the colon, starting the condition. Therefore, some infants with exaggerated ileocecal invagination and the ileocecal angle, which is the angle between the ileum and cecum, is very acute like that, predisposed to ileocecal intussusception. Or this fold, which is called ileocecal fold. This peritoneal fold may pull the terminal ileum towards the cecum. If well developed in infancy, it actually pulls the terminal ileum towards the cecum, allowing ileocecal intussusception. Or there may be abnormal mobility of cecum. If the cecum is abnormally mobile, the cecum will move around the terminal ileum, starting the condition of intussusception. Pathologically, what is the pathology of ileocecal intussusception? The ileocecal valve is the leader or the apex of intussusception. It passes into the cecum. And if the condition is neglected, the ileocecal valve may pass toward the ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and may descend inside the rectum and the anal canal. The intussusception pathologically consists of many layers. What are the layers of intussusception? This drawing is very useful. This is the abscessical valve, which is called the apex of intussusception, and actually it is the leader of intussusception. What is this? This layer of ileum proximal to the abscessical valve enter inside the colon. This is called entering layer, which is actually the wall of the terminal ileum. On the terminal ileum, the colon becomes reflected over the terminal ileum. This layer is called returning layer. This mass inside the lumen of the colon, which consists of entering layer and returning layer, it is called intussusceptum. Therefore, the intussusceptum is the inner mass inside the lumen of the colon and consists of entering and returning layers, with the apex between the entering and returning layer, and it is the leader of intussusception, and pathologically called the apex of intussusception. What is this? This layer surround the intussusceptum. The inner mass is called intussusceptum. This layer surround the intussusceptum and called the ensheathing layer, the layer of colon which ensheathes the intussusceptum. This ensheathing layer is called intussusception. The junction between the returning layer and the ensheathing layer, this is called neck or base of intussusception. This is the neck of intussusception. You should notice that the apex is fixed, which is the ileocecal valve, and it will progress, and the leader of intussusception inside the colon. While the neck of intussusception is changing according to the progression of intussusceptum, if the intussusceptum progresses to here, the neck enter inside the colon and becomes a part of the returning layer. Therefore, as it progresses, the neck enter to become part of the returning layer, while the leader, which is the ileocecal valve, is the ileocecal valve, not changed, and progress inside the colon and moves inside the colon and may descend from the anal canal. The mesentery of small intestine, containing the blood vessels supplying the small intestine, becomes compressed between the entering and the returning layer, leading to ischemia and strangulation and gangrene, where in the most point away from the blood supply, here the compression, and where is the point which is as far as possible from the blood supply, which is the apex of intussusception. This is the first part to be strangulated and becomes gangrene. For the Arabic student, أنا بشبه دائما intussusception لو أنا عمل زي المظاهرة. قائد المظاهرة شايل العلم اللي هو الإليوسيكال فالف بيتقدم المظاهرة وقاعد بيهتف وماشي قدام هو المتقدم المظاهرة. واللي ماشي وراه دول المتظاهرين اللي هو الإليوم. نبص نلاقي أول واحد هيموت وهياخد رصاص من الشرطة مين؟ هو المتقدم المسيرة اللي هو الايبكس اوف انتسسبشن اللي هو الليدر بتاعنا. The inner mass, which is the intussusceptum, becomes congested, and this congestion leading to rupture of the venule inside the lumen of the colon, and the congestion leading to excessive mucus secretion from the mucous membrane of the colon. This lead to the colon becomes filled with mucus, excessive mucus with blood. And this mucus with blood pass from the anal canal as red currant jelly diarrhea. For the Arabic student, عامل زي الصوص بتاع مربة كريز. Which is actually mucus and blood. What is the complication of intussusception? As the usual complication in the general principle of intestinal obstruction. We will continue in the next video. Thank you for good listening and good luck.